Howdy folks, we are actually going to do a complete diag video on, well, even though it's going to be a short video, it's actually a long format video, so I know this is going to be over an hour. I'll try and break it up into sections, but first off, we're going to start with electrical. Okay, electrical systems can be pretty much broken down into battery starting and charging, lighting, and ancillary equipment. Ancillary equipment could be a electric clutch for the PTO, such as like this one, it's got the anti-backfire valve. Yeah. Okay. This one's got the anti-backfire valve. Lighting. Or if you've got a few accessories like a heated seat, that's it. Electronic locking diff. That's more transmission, but it could just be electrical to the transmission. So, there's that. Now, there's a few of these systems that I have mentioned that this tractor does not have. It does not have the electronic clutch. It does not have the electronic locking diff in the tranny. But this does have the anti-backfire valve. No, this doesn't have a heated seat. Although heated seats are relatively easy to figure out when you get into them. So, let's bring you around to the battery. Now, another thing about this, folks, is just like your car, a lawn tractor has a battery to start the engine. But there's also fuses. Some of them are hidden way up in your steering column section. Some of them are hidden back here at the battery. We're going to start with when you got a battery. This one's a brand new one. And I just took it off the charger. So this one should read a healthy voltage, which healthy voltage. Now you're going to want your meter, if you're checking battery voltage, on the DC scale. This is a direct current system. Although you're going to want to get yourself a meter with AC capabilities, because some parts of your charging system are actually AC. 12.91, that's a fully charged battery. Now, a fully charged battery is 12.8 or higher. Anywhere from 12.4 to 12.7, that's a used battery. Realistically, 12.4 to 12.5, that's a dead battery. Anything below 12.4, that's flat. It might crank the motor over, but it's flat. And yep, still 12.91 volts. So, one big thing that I see a lot happen, and this is what's weird. Most of your lawn tractors have bolts that hold your cables on. But I see it a lot when I'm working on other people's stuff, to where they don't have these bolts actually tight, or the bolts themselves are so rusted that they can't commit to the current. So I'm just going to finger tighten these screw to even see if this thing runs. If not, I'm going to have to show you folks that these are... Well, hold on. Let me take this phone call. Now, back to what I was saying. I'm just going to hand tighten these, and I'm going to show you, folks, actually what happens. I see, ironically, a lot where, you know, they look tight. Oh, yeah. They look tight. Yeah. Yeah, man. They look tight. Oh, yeah, man. They look tight. You know, and parking brakes on. Oh, yeah, man. They look tight. They look tight. Oh, yeah, they look tight, man. Nothing. Okay? Nothing. Now. All I'm going to do, folks. This is all I'm going to do. Is I'm going to take and tighten the battery cables. Okay? All I'm gonna do. So. That one tight. Now that one is tight. Now, let's see what happens. So, if you're having starting problems, come back to your battery, because these bolts can actually vibrate loose as well. So, don't just think that they will stay tight. Another thing is that, just like any other battery, you're going to have corrosion that comes up in here. Clean off the corrosion. Sometimes that's all it takes, is to clean off the corrosion, give the battery a little bit of juice from a battery charger, because if they're corroded, that means they're not letting current in, because if it's not letting current out, it ain't letting current in, so... But now, we have a battery. Let's start with the engine diag. Now, what's really wrong with this, folks, is I'm getting an intermittent miss. Sometimes the one cylinder's falling flat on its face. And then you idle it down. Sometimes you can hear this pop, 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 pop. So it's got an intermittent miss. Now, if you were, say, in a shop setting doing this, and a customer came in and said, oh, yeah, I'm getting lack of power, you know. I'm usually able to cut through this such and such grass, but it doesn't do it anymore. Well, okay. Number one, are the blades sharp? You know, if the blades ain't sharp, you know, it ain't gonna cut through much of anything, and it's gonna take more power off the mower. The motor to keep those blades spinning. Well, if the blades are sharp, move on to the motor. Now, got the pressure gauge out, because we're gonna check compression, just in case it's a compression problem. We're gonna pull the spark plugs, Now, make sure that when you're pulling the plugs, you remember to put them someplace where you can actually have an idea of which cylinder they came out of. Because if not, that really wrecks your diagnostic process. Another thing that you can check real quick, because if you're not the one that maintains the machine, you're not going to realize this, but air filters. I have seen these suckers plumb full of crap in them, where this filter's black, they're just garbage, they're junk all over. And these are actually fairly easy to pull out and check. But, you know, say you're the one that's always working on this machine. You probably already know that. Now, cylinder one. It's what our plug looks like. Pretty clean burn. Okay? That's really clean burn. Actually out of a carbureted engine, that's a really nice clean burn pattern. Now, put that cover back on. Now let's pull number two. Pulling number two. There again, pretty clean burn. It's starting to burn a little harsh right there. We might have to actually check into that. Other than that, we're actually doing a clean burn fairly well. So, now, we're gonna put a compression tester in it. Have it at rabbit without any choke when you're doing compression testing. Now, you want to start doing this after you've checked all the basic maintenance items. Your blades, your air filter, your fuel filter, because these are items that can cause poor performance. Now, I just know that you folks like watching me play with the tools. Got 100 psi of cranking compression. So, that's good pressure. Now, let's check this cylinder. Come on. That one's actually got more compression. That one's almost got 100. Heck, that's got 145 psi of compression. So, what are we thinking? Well, could be a valve in here that's not sealing. Probably want to do a cylinder leak down test. Unfortunately, I don't own one of those tools. Although I'm probably going to have to buy one for us to play with. But it's clean burning on the spark plug. So, yeah. Now, another problem with these intake motors, there's a few of them. The intake manifolds, the cams, they like to all go out. Okay. So we've got that covered. Okay. Why is it that one cylinder has got more compression than the other? That's a big question in my mind. Because that's more than just the 10% between cylinders. So why is it that we're having issues with this cylinder but not with the other one? We'll probably crack into the motor. Don't know if we're going to do that today in this video, but we'll probably crack into the motor. Now, another big problem that I'm already starting to see, if I come over here to this side of the engine, I'm seeing this side's wet, and I can feel it. It's oil, it's not gasoline, and it's spewing up under the pump, versus this side, which this is clean. So, with that in mind, folks, that could be an indication of problems. And see, it's even spewed onto the spark plug wire. Ooh, that plug wire is actually coming out of the boot. Huh. So, we're going to chase that down right now. We're not going to deal with the mechanical right now. We're going to chase down that ignition system. Is the ignition system good enough to actually create spark? And good clean spark at that. Now, there's two different types of testers. There's just the basic one. Then there's this style, which has a threaded screw that's gonna force it to jump between the two points. Now, this is the one we're actually gonna use today because, well, we need to find out how good that spark is. Set it for 30 thousandths, clip it onto something heavy. Now, bring it over, bring you folks over so that you can actually see what the heck we're doing. Yeah. And I'm gonna bring you, wrong way. So, we're gonna do that and we're gonna crank. Actually, this side ain't producing no spark, huh? Not good spark. Let's crank it down. See if we can get any spark out of it. Okay, we can see spark. Now let's crank it wide. Let's crank her open. Problem is that we're out in the sunlight, so it's harder than heck to see. Maybe you actually saw it better than I did. Let me take the sunglasses off. So it's got spark, but not real good spark. It's not able to jump that gap real well. You know? And this is under cranking part, you know, with one spark plug pulled. So, let's see. If we bring it down to like a, probably a 25 thousandths gap, what would be the equivalent? Huh. Folks, I think we might have found a reason for our problem. We've got a weak, it'll fire, but it ain't gonna burn that fuel correctly. So we're probably actually washing this cylinder out. So there's probably excessive wear on this cylinder versus the other side, and that's probably why we actually have low compression on the one side. So well, let me crank this out a little more, because, you know, yep. But let's try it on the other side. We're gonna see if we can jump the gap. Oh boy, yeah, this is oily. Okay, I should bring you out. Whoa. For the time being. Well, we're gonna see if this side will even jump the gap. Mark, or we're just talking about a weak ignition system, which if both sides are weak, I'm actually going to lean more towards the diode, which means we're going to have to pull the top cover. We're going to have to do a diode check. Okay. I see it. We got some weak sparkage going on. Yeah. Might be that diode in there. But we got weak spark. Now, the weird thing is that this side has a weaker spark than this side. But I think we're gonna have to lean towards this boot and the fact that this, we're gonna have to lean towards this boot. Because this whole thing is just full of oil. This boot is just full of oil. We're gonna have to replace this valve cover gasket because that's obviously leaking. And see if we can't get a boot. We got nice compression, even though we have an imbalance. We got a little bit of a weaker spark than we should, folks. So let's just fire this thing up and let's see if we can even get it to run. Because, you know, there's a lot of white stuff around us right now. So. We're gonna put the cover back on. We got fuel in the tank. Do we got fuel in the tank? So yeah, if your maintenance items, such as your fuel filter, your air filter, if that's all good, then you gotta move on to the ignition, carburetor. Now putting spark plugs for like a V-twin on either side of the seat, that's usually the way I do it to tell which plug goes where. Now, I don't believe in that, oh, they wear in thing, but the thing is that for diagnostic purposes, you want to put them back in the same place. Okay, and where's my ratchet? So far we have diagnosed that we do have spark. It's a little weak, which could mean the diode that runs between the two. But the thing is that if that diode checks up, then you gotta go through your wiring up to the key switch and find out where the short is to ground. It could just be a small short to ground. So, but you gotta pull your top cover. And if you're having a bit of fuel issues, you might, when you're in the top cover, especially on these V-twins, you might as well take the carburetor out if you're doing it yourself. If you're working for a shop, you gotta freaking talk to your shop manager and all that. Clean out the carb. So, we're actually, by the looks of the plugs, we're almost running lean. A little on the leaner side of life, so. Yeah, I don't like the way that those go on. Okay. Let me bring you back. And choke. Contact. a different noise, then you can suspect a gasket or the intake manifold itself. But, pretty sure that intake manifold is good. And yeah, it took a little while to start up, but once it started up, with the engine idled down, you can hear that it's running on plug. But you can hear that on. You know, these engines are actually fairly balanced from the factory, so to have that slight miss to them that you can pick up on, let's see if I can get the camera to hear it. I guess we're going to be digging into an ignition system. Plus, we need to fix that valve cover gasket. Which actually, this valve cover gasket is probably the reason that this cylinder... this cylinder might actually be missing due to this. So we fixed the mechanical, fired up again, and diagonal from there. From this point forward, we can't do anything until we get parts. So, right now, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.